Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Inizalea, and today I'll be showing you how to create an awesome plane flyover effect just like this one. Alright, so that looks really cool, and we're going to do this entire thing in Adobe Premiere Pro, which is actually pretty cool because normally it would go for After Effects in this case, but I wanted to challenge myself to do this inside of Premiere Pro, and I was actually inspired for this shot because last Saturday I actually went to a concert of Bruno Mars together with my girlfriend, and she's a really big fan, but very close by there was an airport, so every minute there was like a plane just flying over the concert, which was really epic. And yeah, on some occasions I was just so inspired by the view. It looked so epic, and I wanted to recreate that with visual effects in Adobe Premiere Pro. So yeah, it was a really cool day. I really enjoyed it a lot. Although I really had to stand like all day and my feet really hurt at the end of the evening. It was a really amazing time I had there. But yeah, that inspired me to create this shot. So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and see how it is done. Alright, so if you enjoyed watching my intro, I'm actually giving that for free. A link will be put in the description. I have a shorter version of my intro that you can edit in Adobe Premiere Pro or After Effects. Change the text, change the colors, completely for free. So I will put a link in the description. And if you enjoy watching this video, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And let's get started. Good, so here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro. I have these files prepared, so you can also go ahead and download these. The first is a tripod shot of the air with some clouds moving, and that's it. What I will do is just drag it and drop it here in a new sequence, and then we have this video file here. I will also import a sound effect, which I can share with you guys because it's not copyright free. I actually downloaded it somewhere and I really don't remember where, so I can't really tell you where I found the sound effect. But what you should do is just search for a plane pass by sound effect and use that, because that's immediately going to change the entire atmosphere of your plane animation. So we'll import that in just a second. So now what we want to do is click on the image plane flyover. This is just a plane that I took off Google. I cut it out in Photoshop. I assume that everyone knows how to cut out an image, so I'm not going to include that in this tutorial. It's just a PNG image. I will drag this into my timeline just like so. So now we have a super big plane, which isn't really what we are looking for, but yeah, you could also go for a plane crash, for example, or a super close flyover. I rather like to make it a little bit more realistic, so like I'm going to size it to like 25, I think, and that looks all right. Then I will click our actually even smaller, because it's actually working in a lower resolution, so maybe 17. Let's go for 17 and scale. That looks about right. I'm also going to kind of hover it over the house, because that's also something I like to do to make something more realistic, is to play with depth, play with masks, and that instantly makes something more realistic. So the first thing that we'll do is actually click on the motion here, and that will make the square around my plane. I will just position it kind of off screen like this, and then I will create a keyframe for the position and for the scale. So what I will do is go and move over to near the end of the clip and click on the motion, and then just move the plane to the right and kind of position it over here, I suppose, or something like that. So a straight line like this. So we'll create, that will automatically create a new keyframe. I'm also going to click on the scale and kind of make it a little bit smaller, so we are playing with some depth. It's going smaller, so it's actually taking more distance from the camera. So I will select these two keyframes and just kind of position them at the end of my clip. Actually, I just want like 7 seconds or 10 seconds long. So what I'll do is just click, drag my keyframes over here, select everything and just make it shorter. And there we have our plane animation. So let's see what we have. We have about a nice speed. It's going, it's very high in the sky, so the speed doesn't have to be so fast. Okay, so we have our plane. That's the first thing we needed to do. The next thing we need to do is make sure that we're satisfied with the animation. We don't want to change it afterwards, because in Premiere Pro, it doesn't allow us much freedom with applying VFX. In Adobe After Effects, you can do a lot of cool things, which are honestly a lot easier, but I just wanted to challenge myself to do it in Premiere. So how I did it is I also prepared these lights here, a green light and a red light, and honestly, that makes the entire shot so much more realistic because we actually have some animation, and that will distract the audience of thinking it's an actual image. They will actually think faster that it's actually a plane flying over because there is some minor animation in there. So what I'll do is zoom in on my timeline a little bit and drag my light on top here. And the thing is, you have to make sure your animation is fixed because once you want to change it later, you will have to manually change every single light. But we're going to use the effects controls here and also lower the scale to something like 10 or maybe like 20. 20 looks fine. And then for the blending mode, we'll change it to a screen. So now we have the light and we can click on our motion and bring it like over here. And by the way, for the people that think you could work with a nested composition or nested sequence, it didn't work because the screen blending mode didn't come true. So I tried that first. Fortunately, that's not a solution. So, okay, we have our light one frame further. I will actually zoom a little bit more in my timeline. One frame further, I just want to cut my clip and delete the rest of the part. So we just have like for one frame a light. So maybe we want to start the light here. Or actually for two frames could also work. Okay, two frames, there we go. Then one frame, two frames further, we're going to apply the green light and also make it two frames long. So we're going to also make this 20. Move it to the other wing and set it to screen. And now we already have our two lights. One here, then the green one. And then a little bit later, we actually need another red. So I'm going to hold Alt and bring this one over here and click on the motion and just move it over to somewhere around here. This is going to be like the center light, which is not going to flicker as much as the wing lights. So there we go. Now what we want to do is select these two, and a little bit further in time, we want to hold Alt and just drag them in here. And then a little bit further in time, we want to drag all of them in here. So select all of them, Alt and drag. So now we have like the two lights flickering, the main light flickering, the two lights flickering, no main light. So we have a little bit of a kind of a delay and kind of an offset. So to make it a little bit more organic. So next one you wanna do is go in each individual light and reposition it to the plane position. So we have to click over here, click on this one, motion, move it over to this wing over here, and just do that for every single light. Perfect, so you can do it one more time, select everything, hold Alt and drag it. Here we can delete the green light because it's actually covered by the chimney. And there we go, I think this is enough. So we have this nice animation and instantly you can see that it looks already a lot more realistic than it used to be being an image. So, okay, we have this start. Now what I wanna do is click on my original footage and hold Alt and drag it on top. So the plane is gone. We want to click on that footage and go to our pen tool. Make sure we are seeing enough of our house. So maybe we want to make this a little bit bigger, 150 maybe, and kind of draw a mask around the chimney and the basic kind of roof of the house. So it doesn't have to be perfect. You can still kind of change it later on in time. Once you're satisfied, you can move these a little bit like this. Zoom in a little bit more if you want to or need to. But I think we have it basically set up correctly. Okay, so once you've done your mask, you can go and close it over here. And now we have a mask of our chimney. So we want to set the feather to 2 and let's see what that does. If the plane is hovering over here, looks pretty okay. We can click on here and maybe go to the mask expansion and just lower it by 1 because we had a feather of 2 and that way it kind of covers it perfectly. Okay, so creating depth instantly makes it much more realistic. Okay. So we have our shot here of our plane. The only thing is the plane doesn't really fit the scene. The scene is very kind of cloudy, grayish, kind of desaturated. So we can click over here and go for our plane and go to the Lumetri color panel. If you don't see that, you can go to window and Lumetri color, which is over here. And the first thing that I want to do is just lower the kind of saturation intensely. And also lower the contrast intensely because it's a very soft contrast scene. Maybe the blacks, we also want to increase those and go to the creative tab and increase kind of the faded fill, which does something like this. You can also lower the whites if you want to, make a little bit more gray. And for the creative tab, we can also lower the sharpness maybe because it's in a far distance, so it's not going to be extremely sharp. So now we have this. If you look before and after, it kind of fits the scene a lot better, in my opinion. Okay, so the color grading is done. Then lastly, what we want to do is hold Alt, click on this original footage, hold Alt and bring it on top again. And now what we want to do is just play with the opacity. So in the beginning, maybe you have something like 80 opacity. Over here, we have something lower, maybe like 10. A little bit further, we have like maybe 50 or 40. A little bit further, we have 100 or no, 78. And very soft. And maybe at the near end, a little bit higher. So what I will do is kind of make the clouds come true and make kind of a depth in the clouds. It's like the plane is actually flying through the clouds and it's really going to make it intensely more realistic. So you can see that it's now like it's actually passing clouds and it's not always as visible, which is just amazing. Okay, so that looks pretty good. We have a nice animation going here. We want to select all of our layers that we just created. And we want to right click and go for a nest. Nest the sequence as a plane sequence. And now we want to do a final touch. Well, for one, we want to apply the sound effect. So I can cut it here when it's a little bit louder. And let's see. I actually forgot to paste this one also, so I'm going to cut it and paste it over here. Okay, a little mistake I did there. But okay, we have the sound effects. And now to make it dramatically more realistic, everything that you record on a tripod, it's very easy to assume it's visual effects because you don't need to do tracking. Everyone can easily apply effects to it. So to kind of hide that imperfection, or yeah, even to hide imperfections, like I just said, you can apply something called camera shakes from organic and real cameras and that we track down. And we actually have a pack for that. I will also put a link in the description, DC Camera Shake Preset 2.0. If you open it up, you can see that we have hard shakes, low shakes, medium shakes. I think a medium shake would do fine and for an establishing shot. So something like this, we just apply it to the scene and immediately you will see that it zooms in a little bit because there is a little bit of an animation going. And as you can see now, it's like I'm filming this with my phone. It's like I'm filming this in a realistic way. We didn't do any tracking, but yeah, it just looks so much more realistic in my opinion. And this just makes the shot entirely. And then of course, lastly, you can go ahead and maybe add an adjustment layer on top of this entire thing. So new adjustment layer, click OK and drag it on top here. And maybe you want to go for a, we'll zoom out a little bit. Maybe you want to apply a LUT to the entire thing to make it even more blended in together so the colors really match. So we can go to the creative tab and browse for a LUT. And there we go. So now we have this LUT applied, which makes the color a little bit better and everything fit a little bit better together. So completely up to you. What I like to do is maybe nest it one more time and add a crop to the effect. I'm actually going to position this, or I'm going to position it up a little bit, something like this, and add a crop effect. Now we have this kind of film shot. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and definitely hit that bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers and motion graphics artists. And apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.